Hi, my name is Dave Smith, and we are going on module 2. This time we're talking about grandpa. So in the first part of this module, part 1, we talked about grandma and how she was, you know, admitted status post-reindeer collision, but it left grandpa left to his own devices and his own medications, but probably nothing could go wrong, right? Until breakfast time. But today we're actually going to try and talk about how you might start to recognize adverse drug events in your geriatric patient, just like grandpa. So who's grandpa? He's 82-year-old, and he comes to you with his chief complaint of dizziness. Grandpa's been married to grandma for 52 years, but for the last 10, it's actually grandma who managed most of his medications. So like any 82-year-old, he's got a fair number of chronic disease states, including BPH, congestive heart failure, atrial fibrillation, hypertension, gout, and insomnia. And imagine this, he comes into your clinic and he hands you this med list. So just take a second and see how much of this actually makes sense to you. So once you're used to looking at this, you'll probably see that on the left-hand side, you have furosemide, atorvastatin, warfarin, omeprazole, and allopurinol. On the right side, a whole nother list of meds. You have 13 altogether. So this makes you think, here's grandpa, he's 80 years old, lots of chronic disease and a lot of medications. Which one of these do you actually think is going to be the greatest predictor of an adverse drug event? If you picked B, you were right. That is actually the reason for the number of medications is so great that anytime grandpa comes to you with a new sign or symptom, you should consider it to be an adverse drug reaction until you've proven it otherwise and attribute it to something else. So adverse drug reactions can be difficult to identify in elderly because they might present as confusion or delirium, falls, fractures, hypotension, functional decline, urinary incontinence or retention. Remember, those are a lot of the same symptoms that we saw in the online module part 1 that can be adverse drug reactions, but they can be mistaken for just normal aging. But most of these are not part of the normal aging process. Now, how do you even start dealing with this with grandpa? Imagine he comes into your clinic or you go to his home for a home visit and he hands you those med lists. What are you supposed to do? The first thing is to think, is he even taking these medications? And if so, or if he isn't, is it because he can't afford them? He doesn't know why he's supposed to take them? Does he not believe in if they work for him? You should also understand, does he have any new medications that was prescribed he didn't even know he should be taking? And that med list, how do you even know that med list is accurate? Maybe it's from 6 months ago. You're not sure. And so your job is to be a detective and try and find out from grandpa. Call grandma, who's over in her skilled nursing facility. Look into your EMR. Call the local pharmacy. But the most important thing is you can't determine what adverse drug events may be there unless you have an accurate medication list. So, which drugs should you worry about? You go through all this trouble to get an accurate med list, and then you think, I don't even know which meds I should worry about. So you could memorize all the drugs, and that would probably actually make most of the pharmacists a little bit jealous. You could go to your online blog post like Student Forum Doctor. You could consult the all-knowing Google, or maybe hope you get a really nice pharmacist at the 24-hour Walgreens. None of those are an exceptionally bad idea, but there are probably some proven reputable sources you could go to as well. The first is the Beers list. This is a list that was started a while back, and it gives potentially inappropriate medications for elderly. It's actually going to be revised in 2016, and it does a really good job of just starting to build your radar of what to worry about. Another one is a start and stop criteria, which focuses a little bit more on drugs that should be present or discontinued, usually based on disease state or prognosis of your elderly patient. And this is also a time when, if you didn't go back and look at Module 1, where grandma got run over by a reindeer, there are classes in general, like anticholinergic medications, that you should just be wary of anytime you suspect an adverse drug event or reaction. Now, drug-drug interactions, there's no way we can go over all of them. So I do invite you to look in the course syllabus on table 7 and 8 to look at some common examples of that. With regards to drug interactions or just identifications, Micromedics and Lexicomp are two of the more reputable sources that are going to be available at all of your rotational sites for the three main hospitals here in San Francisco. You can bookmark them on the computer if it isn't already. An app that I know a lot of physicians like is Hippocrates. It's very easy to use. And if all you have is the internet, drugs.com actually, when you're looking at drug interaction and IDs, is actually fairly good, and most of the information comes from Micromedics and LexiComp. So let's bring this back to Grandpa. So remember, he came with some dizziness. He has BPH, heart failure, AFib, gout, and hypertension. Now, he's on 3 blood pressure medications and a diuretic. So we learned in Module 1 that all of those may not actually be very easy for Grandpa's body to handle. So you have to think, is his blood pressure at goal for an 82-year-old? And if it's not, is there any way that you could attribute to one of these medications? Another thing that you should consider is that he's on 2 medications that might cause bleeding, warfarin and aspirin. So is he bleeding? Is maybe he's losing blood and it's causing some hypovolemia, and he's not actually compensating very well? Those are 2 things that you might actually consider given this complicated medication list. So take home point from adverse drug reactions: any new symptom should be considered a drug reaction until you can prove otherwise. Make sure you get an accurate med list. Start to become familiar with some of those drug databases you can look up, and try and reference things like the Beers list to identify dangerous drugs in your elderly patients. Thank you.